Didn't he love? Didn't he shine? So let his light come brightly shining. Let it shine on you and me. Let it wash away all fear and sorrow. Let it set us free. Oh, the people called him Jesus. He was a man for all time. Just a simple man called Jesus. But didn't he love? Didn't he shine? Didn't he shine? Didn't he shine? Didn't he
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already gone. 'Tis grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. Lead me home. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun.
salutaris hostia quae celi pandis hostium bella premunt hostilia daro vor fer auxilium unitrino quae dominum sit sempiterna gloria qui vitam sine termino nobis donet in patria.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
We adore you, O most holy Lord Jesus Christ, here in all your churches throughout the world.
And we bless you because by our most holy cross you have redeemed the world.
The love of Christ has gathered us together.
Let us rejoice in him and be cheerful. Let us love the living God and love each other with honest hearts. Let us take care not to be isolated in ourselves. Let ill will, quarrels, and disagreements stop, and Christ our Lord be among us.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, you have made us for yourself. Our hearts are restless until they rest in you. Fulfill this longing through Jesus, the bread of life, so that we may witness to him who alone satisfies the hungers of the human family. By the power of your Spirit, lead us to the heavenly table, where we may feast on the vision of your glory forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. We know that God makes all things work together for the good of those who have been called according to his decree. Those whom he foreknew, he predestined to share the image of his Son, that the Son might be the firstborn of many brothers. Those he predestined, he likewise called. Those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he in turn glorified. What shall we say after that? If God is for us, who can be against us? Is it possible that he who did not spare his own Son, but handed him over for the sake of us all, will not grant us all things besides? Who shall bring a charge against God's chosen ones? God who justifies? Who shall condemn them? Christ Jesus, who died, or rather was raised up, who is at the right hand of God and who intercedes for us? Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Trial or distress or persecution or hunger? Nakedness or danger or the sword? As the scripture says, for your sake we are being slain all day long. We are looked upon as sheep to be slaughtered. Yet in all this we are more than conquerors because of him who has loved us. For I am certain that neither death nor life, neither angels nor principalities, neither the present nor the future nor powers, neither height nor depths, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God that comes to us in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, "Let me solemnly assure you, if you do not eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. He who feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood has life eternal, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is real food, and my blood real drink. The man who feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me and I in him. Just as the Father, who has life, sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so the man who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors, who ate and died nonetheless, the man who feeds on this bread shall live forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you. Thank you. Sanctum ergo sacramentum veneremus cernui et anticum documentum novo cedat ritui prestet fides supplementum sensum defectui genitori genitoque laus jubilatio salus honor vitus quoque sire benedictio procedenti ab utroque et comparsit laudatio. Amen. Amen.
You have given them bread from heaven. Alleluia.
The source of all happiness. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you give us the Eucharist as a memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of the sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of the kingdom where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and his saints.
O
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine, be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine, be every moment thine.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Nauči nás, Gospod.